Syria has now lasted for 7 years. It's claimed over 120,000 civilian lives, mostly by conventional and non-chemical weapons since 2011. The conflict in Syria has also been one of the most heavily documented ones, particularly with video, and social media platforms have been a key repository for visual evidence from inside of Syria. Key stakeholders and from the international community to local organizations have really been relying on this data to inform and strengthen the reporting efforts and advocacy efforts.
The main point why we started the Syria Archive, it was as a start to a repository to be able to preserve this type of documentation, but also false information was a big part of what's happening in Syria since the beginning. So verification was something that is really important to tackle. Part of the goal is making sure that all this documentation is organized and all is curated in one place where it can be also tagged with relevant materials. It can be contextualized and it can be more understandable for any people who wants to use it. What we have been working on is a transparent methodology and a transparent way of sharing all the tools that we are using to document human rights violations in Syria, and mainly focus on visual documentation. There are also the resources that have been published by WITNESS, especially the one related to video as evidence. And this is really this was really important for us to try to design the metadata schema of the of our collection, and also the process and the workflow.
We started the video as evidence guide because we were working in Syria and we were doing video advocacy. So basically collecting video for media, collecting video to take to the UN, take to the Security Council, etc. And the world wasn't acting. The world wasn't responding to media reports. So it was the activists and the lawyers in Syria that asked us, hey, would you guys help us to preserve this video for long-term justice and accountability? The International Criminal Court was making a request to NGOs to start up first responders program so that that absolutely critical evidence that was on the ground would not be lost simply because a professional international investigator could not get in. We started working on guidance with the Syrian Institute for Justice. And so we tested those protocols, wrote those protocols, worked with those in the field, and then basically shared those internationally because it wasn't just Syrians that were struggling with how to collect evidence that's reliable and relevant. It was everyone. The guide itself and the trainings itself are meant to be tailored, are meant to help people on the ground so that they can document the violations that are happening to them and that they can make sure that that documentation is one, reliable, and second, relevant. Mm-hmm. If you get trial-ready information, while it might never be used in court, it can be used for advocacy, it can be used by the media, and it will be able to be verified quickly, which is very important when you have mass amounts of media, and it will be able to be trusted.
There are continuing calls from governments around the world to take down so-called extremist content in a very rapid way. You know, these are not platforms that were created for human rights purposes, but that is how they're being used. Really recently, what we're seeing is the use of algorithms to take down content. We have been working to get those videos restored, and there are people who are really dedicated to helping us on that issue. So we've gotten also thousands of videos restored, but it's the issue that they get taken down in the first place, and potentially it's really valuable content that is being lost. It's the right thing is to make sure that the material that's out there is actually making an impact on what people are experiencing, right? So you can't counter extremist content if you are just deleting it and throwing it away and not getting it to the right place. And not verifying it and using it for justice. I think the onus right now is really on platforms to do better at explaining what their policies are. And, you know, we're seeing movement there, so that's good. And then providing better avenues when the policies and tools go wrong. So transparency and really clear appeals processes are incredibly important. I guess I'll say in the meantime, for people who want to keep their content up, the most important thing you can do is make sure that it's clear that it is human rights related content in whatever way you can, and try to do that within the frame of the video itself.